You know, the CBC seems to be cropping up in the news a lot lately. They're not talking about nothing, but they're actually showing up and acting as if they're concerned about the black community, where we know they're not. So, Congressional Black Caucus unveiled day one agenda in participation of Jeffries becoming House Speaker. So, y'all, the Congressional Black Caucus is now concerned about the top issues impacting the black community. And this is what they're saying are the top issues: protecting voting rights, diversity, equity, and inclusion, and reproductive freedoms. There is nothing on here about reparations, nothing about a crime bill, nothing about doing something about qualified immunity. Those things aren't, I guess, to the CBC, those are not things of concern. Those are not things of concern for the black community. So they had an event, ladies and gentlemen, CBC Black Media Salon, and April Ryan, she was the moderator. The event was held at a Washington, D.C. office of progressive advocacy group People for the American Way. Black reporters from various outlets attended to hear from CBC leaders about what's next for their policy agenda. Well, I tell you what, if you're not talking about reparations, a crime bill, or qualified immunity, then you're not talking about anything of concern for the black community. So this is what they're saying. The issues of Black America are very important. Ryan, the longest serving Black female House, White House reporter in U.S. history. We're watching our laws be eroded. We're watching a time now called post-affirmative action era, Ryan added. It was important for people, including me, to hear what they had to say. During the panel, the CBC members discussed how they plan to advocate for reproductive rights. They're talking about the A word. Combat efforts to defund historically black colleges and universities, HBCUs. Lower the cost of housing. Protect voting rights. Reform the U.S. Supreme Court. Ensure diversity, inclusion, and equity are upheld in the workplace. That's what y'all discussed. Wow. There are forces working to take away the very tools of economic opportunity and freedoms that we have fought so hard to advance, said CBC Chairman Horsford. We are going to hold everyone accountable. We don't have permanent friends or permanent enemies. We have permanent interests. So earlier this month, White House Democrats held their annual retreat. They told reporters that their motto for 2024 is finish the job. Are you kidding me? What job? Y'all don't do nothing. So they said this is an attempt to win back the House majority in the upcoming 2024 general election. Wow. In a previous interview, Rep. Jasmine Crockett of Texas told the GRIO that if voters want to see progress on important issues such as climate change or getting some of our rights back when it relates to reproductive access, they must vote Democrat. See, here it is. We're going to talk about these things and discuss these things, but you have to vote for us. But the problem is, they had this panel and they did not discuss the things that we said are important. they came up with their own agenda and then tried to say, these are the things that are important to the Black community. Well, they sure didn't ask us, did they? We have to do more of explaining legislation and ensuring that the CBC led efforts that translated into simple language versus congressional language. This is what Congresswoman Beatty said. The Ohio lawmaker shared a message for Democratic voters who plan to cast a vote for Trump in the upcoming election. Oh no, here comes the fear tactics, y'all. This is the man who told you to drink bleach. This is the man who threw paper towels to people in Puerto Rico. This is the man who said he could go on Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, and there is nothing you can do about it, Beatty said. That's the alternative to Joe Biden. Yeah, fear, 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 fear tactics, fear tactics. So Horsford told, he said he believes Black voters have the right, have an opinion and have perspective, explaining we are not monolithic. However, the CBC chair believes those who vow to vote for Trump will be disenchanted or misinformed. He acknowledged that's on us. No, actually, that's on the Democratic Party, because you got all this opportunity to do something for the Black community, and y'all don't want to do anything beyond talking. So no, it's on you, Horsford. It's on you and the Democratic Party. You know, one thing you're not going to do, if y'all don't win, you're not shifting the blame to us. You had all this time to do something for the Black community, just like you did for all the others. And you are still failing. We're not taking the blame for that. Because when you attempt to put it on us, we're going to shove it right back on you. Horsford continued, we're to blame for them not knowing that we lifted 50% of children out of poverty, doubled the number of loans to Black-owned businesses in the last 3 years from the SBA. We are seeing record low unemployment. And the CBC created legislation that gave way to the largest investment in HBCUs. None of those things help anyone in the Black community with their immediate situation. None of those things have made our lives better. What are we supposed to do? What if you don't go to an HBCU? Okay. Many of us don't. What about the people that have jobs and not businesses? Or the people, you got a population of people out here with grown children, and or they don't have children at all. Everybody don't have children. So a person in that situation wouldn't benefit at all on the things you just presented. There is no one in the U.S. House of Representatives who has done more to advance the interests of Black America than the CBC and our members, he added. Really? Well, right now, y'all have not done any of the things we want. Ivy told the griot that to defeat Republicans this November, congressional members and President Biden must meet voters where they are. And I mean, let's be real, they're not interested in the issues that we are talking about online. If we weren't talking on social media, you would never hear talk of reparations in the mainstream news or from any of the politicians. you know, and it's very clear they're doing everything they can to avoid the issues that we're interested in. And they keep coming up with these other issues and then claiming this is what the Black community is interested in. And they know darn well we are not interested in any of those things. So this is what they call themselves putting together. But, you know, they said the same typical thing, but you got to vote us in. You got to vote us back in, vote you back in and end up with a fistful of nothing, because that's the way it's been all this time. And people are tired. And the sad part is y'all not tired of playing this benign and neglect game on us. And we're sick of it. So when many of you start getting voted out of office, maybe you'll get the picture then. But tell me what you think about this video. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace, family.